Well, Wolf, you know, it's an eye-catching way to get attention, and an increasing number of liberal activists are throwing glitter at Republican presidential candidates, or at least trying to. And it happened again last night. A college student told CNN he put the glitter up his sleeve and snuck it into an event where Romney was speaking. What happened next? We'll take a look at the pictures. It happened in an instant. Mitt Romney at a rally at the University of Colorado getting glitter bombed, almost. Take a look again in slow motion. The blue glitter right there. Romney, who is now under Secret Service protection, looks momentarily ruffled, but quickly regains his composure. The man who threw the glitter is quickly hustled away by police. CNN tracked him down. He is 20-year-old Peter Lucas Smith, a University of Colorado student majoring in political science. I asked him in this exclusive phone interview why he did it.
Mitt Romney stands for a lot of things that the people of Colorado do not stand for. Be it the LGBT community, be it environmental protection, be it health care reform that he wrote. These are all things he's coming out against, and people in my state I know are very, very concerned about the potential of a Romney presidency.
We reached out repeatedly to the Romney campaign for comment, but we did not receive a response. Glitter bombing, as it's called, began a few months ago as a protest by the gay community over the candidates' positions on same-sex marriage. All four Republican candidates have been targets. It's even made it into mainstream pop culture, featured on the hit show Glee.
You just got glitter bombed.
But it is a huge problem for the Secret Service that has to balance security with access to the candidate. Bill Pickle is a former special agent in charge with the Secret Service. He says the agents did everything right here.
This one you saw talking to Romney a moment ago.
But someone that close to a candidate could throw a substance more harmful than glitter. Another scenario is a glitter bomb could be used as a ruse for a larger second attack.
If this young man throws glitter on the governor and the governor is led away in another direction, the real concern may be where the governor's going, someone who is waiting, knowing he's going to be coming that direction. And that would be the person the Secret Service has a real concern with.
Peter Smith is adamant that he never intended to hurt Romney. He says he was detained for 5 hours by Denver police and questioned by Secret Service and released. Asked if he had any regrets, Smith worried whether this will be a permanent mark on his education and future. But he says he was raised to be politically engaged.
Civil disobedience was something I grew up with on my bookshelf since the age of 7. I understand the importance of standing up. When you see an injustice happening and you feel like you need to speak, I've always thought that's very strong and very important to me.
That is certainly his perspective. Well, the Secret Service gave us a statement saying it, quote, trains its personnel for a wide variety of potential threats that can occur during protection operations. And there is always a balance that has to be struck between security and access, end quote. And as for Peter Smith, well, he was ticketed for disturbance and conducting an unlawful act on school grounds. He faces a $1,000 fine and up to 6 months in jail. And he also faces the real possibility of expulsion from school, Wolf.
And if the Secret Service is protecting a presidential candidate, obviously the stakes are much more intense. So if folks are thinking about glitter bombing, they could go to jail when all is said and done. Is that right, Lisa?
That's right. You know, many people will see this as a prank, as something that's fun, but it really is a serious problem. I mean, the Secret Service, they're not going to reveal all of their methods, but they actually do have various perimeters. I mean, it is very intense what they're doing to make sure that these presidential candidates are protected.